here and this is here, we're actually only needing like that. So all we're doing is needing like that. And the corners, sometimes you do come down like that. So you gotta do that. And then the next one will come.
Looks like a lot of screws and probably overkill, but I just want to make sure it's all right. And as you can see the gaps, the metal was like bending out, so I punched it in so I can get that gap. So now when I lay my plaster, I know I'm not going to have anything sticking through. In this corner I found I made a mistake too. The bead was too flat. It was sticking out somewhat. So I took a hammer and a screwdriver and I just banged it along the edge here. So I perforated the drywall to sink beneath the drywall. Now I'm going to put screws in here. You can see that it's below. There's a gap. Good enough, the plaster will come in and cover that up, and then it'll look fine. kilometers. I gotta fix that up. Let's see here. Fix that up. Look over here. Let's see. Oh, it just needs a touch up. It's gonna crack because it's so much plaster that's gonna crack. So once it cracks and dries, I just go over it with another layer.
I lay the coats down along the edges. It's thick, but it requires you to spend time sanding that, and then what you end up doing is you might end up sanding too much away. So what I'm doing, feathering, and what you do is you go along that edge and you lay a coat out. So it doesn't have to be great, but you go down like that, come up, then you scrape it off. So you scrape off along the edge, because all you're doing is you scrape along the end, having part of your blade still partially on the drywall that you've already applied. So it doesn't look like I put anything on there, but when it dries, it's going to create a layer over top of that edge. So now when I sand, I don't have to sand as much. I just basically sand right over this, like I'm just sanding over the surface. So instead of me concentrating on the edges because they're too thick, I thin it out by feathering it. So now I scrape on this side, the plaster side, and while keeping my blade on, I go down. See? I still got stuff left. Now when it dries, it's going to be nice and smooth. I'm done. I feathered everything out. So now when I sand, instead of focusing on thick edges, now I can just sand right over. And hopefully that's less sanding and less dust in the air. Another trick that I do sometimes, I just cover it up with a piece of tape. So I just put tape just right along the edge, down here, and then I cut it with an X-Acto knife. It doesn't look very nice around the sides here, but that's okay. I can just come by later with some more plaster and fill that in. And then that way, when I take it off, I didn't have to remove my plugs or anything. Go like. Go.
Well, now it's time to start sanding.